That's one end of the cord, and that's the other end of the cord. Hold on a minute. So that's what should be done. And there's a female end and a male end, and they plug into the thing. But never go out when it's been raining, to or when there's water around. Hold on a minute. That right there where the green cap is where there should be oil put into it, because you don't want the motor to the to be ruined, whether it's a lawnmower or anything else. I always check the oil levels. But so then down here there's a place to press the button and then hold that, and that's how it ends up starting. It's important in that, making sure that electrical cords are not anywhere near. I had somebody that was so oblivious to electrical cords that they almost electrocuted themselves when they cut an electrical cord. And I mean, it just was like, they obviously didn't know anything about electrical cords. But there's classes and books on electricity, but there's also a way to end up turning off the fuse box before doing any kind of work on anything, like outlets and that kind of stuff, electrical outlets. I'm not an electrician. My daddy's the one who ended up teaching me a lot of things. If I had things to go do over again, it's part of my fault. But basically, when I was being mistreated at a certain place, I didn't go talk to Daddy about what had happened. And if Daddy had been aware of the situation, he would not have approved of me being bullied. In fact, he would have been outraged that I wasn't taken to a medical doctor in order to get breathing medicine. I bring that up, that that's part of my hatred towards television and some of the other garbage. It breaks up the family unit. I mean, it's sad, the stuff I end up looking at, and it's just like, so many children are starving for their parents' attention. It is very sad to see what's going on. But basically, is that almighty dollar worth it to basically put your children into a daycare with a bunch of strangers, or send them to a school with a bunch of strangers, or whatever else. I mean, I just look at it, and it's just the horrific things that have happened to people, and how there typically has been a propensity to sweep it under the rug for corporate greed. I mean, imagine that. I've seen it happen too many times. Way too many times. That's the reason why it's just like, there comes a period in my life, it's just kind of like, don't want to deal with the crap. Doesn't mean I'm going to murder myself. It just means I'm sick and tired of the crap. I mean, if basically I can figure out who probably ended up doing something, then who else is probably most definitely know who has done something and doesn't think that what they've done is funny. I mean, since when is wicked funny? Since when is wicked something that people would sit there and put on resumes or vitas or whatever else? But it also deals with, don't let the sun go down and the anger. And it's just like, but basically let God deal with them. Let God deal with them. And that's part of the reason why I've been burning some of the stuff that they've given me. It's like, I don't want anything to do with it. It just reminds me of but even then it was more than just them. They were the instrument that was used to do stuff. That the stuff that was going on most definitely took place on the spiritual level. Most definitely, no doubt in my mind. Especially after being spiritually attacked. I mean, I couldn't see anything, but I mean, it's just like, I mean, I could tell something abnormal was going on, and what was my response? Get out as quick as possible. Basically, don't hesitate. Get out. That's the reason why I tend to do what I have control of. Like, I had control of the limb before I drug it up in order to cut it apart. And that's what I'm going to go back to doing. Basically, go back to the simple things that I can do. And basically, let God do my battles for me.